Welcome to Santa Fe, New Mexico, a city different than anywhere else in the world. A city that I had never been to or even known much about until earlier this month when I got the amazing opportunity to partner with Tourism Santa Fe to travel to and capture this beautiful city. Santa Fe is actually the oldest capital in the United States, and it's known for its Pueblo-style architecture and just its incredible art scene, which I had no idea until I got there and I was blown away. You guys know how much I love art, so I really appreciated that. So Alex and I had about 48 hours to explore as much as we could do, see, and obviously eat while we were in Santa Fe. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button right below, and of course give this video a thumbs up if you want more travel guides like this. But let's dive in to where to stay. Santa Fe is home to about 80,000 people, and everything is really walkable or just a short drive away, which I absolutely love because when I'm traveling somewhere, I want to explore as much as possible and not spend a ton of time in a car. So I recommend getting a hotel in the downtown area just so that you can see as much as possible. Everything is really close by. We stayed at the Rosewood Inn of the Anasazi, which is a boutique hotel located near the historic downtown plaza. And it's just 15 minutes from the Santa Fe airport, really convenient. It completely captures the Southwest spirit that I pictured Santa Fe to be and more. It was so cute. It's a great location that's just steps away from all of the shops and the restaurants and the museums that you are definitely not gonna wanna miss when you visit. Like I said, Santa Fe is known for their art, so there are dozens and dozens of museums. But the New Mexico Museum of Arts was actually just a short 3-minute walk away from our hotel, and it has a huge collection of Southwestern arts. Also close by is the Georgia O'Keeffe Museum, which was the most surreal experience for me to visit and see so much of her work firsthand. For those of you who don't know, I was a former art student. I studied and went to so many art classes all my life, so it's such a cool experience being able to like see all of her work in person, ones that I've, you know, admired and been inspired by literally all of my life. Another absolute must see when you go to Santa Fe is Meow Wolf, which was by far my favorite thing that we did on this trip because it was so unique and out of this world. Meow Wolf is an interactive and immersive storytelling experience that's located just about 20 minutes from downtown Santa Fe. We're about to enter Meow Wolf House of Eternal Return. Let's go. We went to the House of Eternal Return, where you walk into this multi-dimensional house that once belonged to a family that's gone missing. So you know I love me a good mystery. There are clues and secret passageways you can explore to discover what happened to this missing family, but it's even more just to explore this vivid sensory world. At first you feel like you're walking into this abandoned old house until you discover the secret passageways like the kitchen fridge or a fireplace that leads you to this alternate dimension or a portal, and it feels a lot like the Upside Down from Stranger Things mixed with Alice in Wonderland. Currently in a portal that I got to through the fridge. Just normal things. What I also love about it is it's truly something that everyone at all ages can enjoy. You're encouraged to explore and touch everything to reach your own narrative and just have your own experience. Like I said, I learned that Santa Fe is one of the world's major centers for art and emerging artists, and I just felt like Meow Wolf really celebrates that in such a beautiful, unique way. And lastly, you must make your way to Canyon Road. It's about a half mile to a mile stretch of about 100 galleries and really cool boutiques and restaurants. With everything from traditional to contemporary works, Canyon Road attracts art collectors from all over the world. Most of the galleries open around 10, so it's a great place to grab brunch and then go after. And it's really fun to just stroll up and down the street and look at all of this original artwork, find some handmade jewelry, or even just grab a bite to eat. Speaking of eating, the food, you guys, in Santa Fe is truly unlike anything you're going to experience anywhere else. I could literally start drooling right now thinking about it. Oh my gosh. I think the food is so special in Santa Fe because of the unique melting pot that makes up the city. And they're known for their really flavorful, rich, and aromatic dishes, especially the green chili. The locals will tell you their biggest question is red or green, which refers to which type of chili you want. So obviously, I had to try their famous green chilies. And I even got one of my dishes Christmas style, which is red and green. So the best of both worlds. I love me some spice, so I pretty much ordered green chilies with every meal that I possibly could. Highly recommend. For breakfast or lunch, definitely check out Sweetwater Harvest Kitchen. All of their dishes are full of organic and locally sourced ingredients. They have everything from vegetarian and vegan options to paleo and gluten-free dishes. So there's truly something that everyone can enjoy. They have everything from breakfast tacos to organic buckwheat pancakes and a killer breakfast burrito, which I got vegan. It's smothered in green chilies and oh my God, it is so good. For your fix of authentic New Mexican food, definitely head to La Choza for lunch or dinner. La Choza is a local favorite and has award-winning red and green chilies, so obviously I had to try both. I ordered their vegetable enchilada Christmas style and holy yum. Also, you have to try their sopapillas, which is a fluffy fried pastry that's so delish, dipped in chili or even drizzled in honey. And they have a huge selection of margaritas, so you can get your fix. Also got to note, Santa Fe has the Margarita Trail. You can try like 45 of the best margaritas in the world. Also check out Dolina for brunch. They have a huge selection of pastries and chilies, which I obviously had to get on my potatoes. Aside from Meow Wolf, another highlight of our trip was definitely going to 10,000 Waves, which is a resort that's inspired by the Japanese mountain hot springs resorts. If you want a fun and relaxing experience or just something a little different to do, definitely go here and have a soak in one of their many outdoor tubs. You can spend an entire day hanging out in one of their communal outdoor tubs for only $28, unlimited for the whole day, which is such an amazing deal. But you can also get your own private tub and sauna, which is what we did, and I highly recommend. Unfortunately, we went at night, so I was unable to capture a lot of footage while we were here, but if you go, you have to grab either lunch or dinner at their Japanese restaurant, Izanami. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Izanami serves small plates, so it's a great place to go with friends, so you can try a bunch of their dishes. They also have a huge sake selection and you get to pick your own cup, which was so fun. We got three different kinds for the table and they were all amazing. Even if you don't go for a soak or a spa treatment, this is a great restaurant that's unlike anything really that they have in the city, and just kind of being up in the mountains a little bit is really fun and pretty. Santa Fe is different than any other city. It's rich in culture, authenticity, and artistic flair. Santa Fe definitely rekindled my love for arts, and I came home with so much inspiration. I just wanna like go to the art store right now and just buy everything in sight. Even just being there 48 hours, I fell in love with Santa Fe and I definitely cannot wait to go back. I'm curious if you guys have ever been, and if you have, definitely comment some recommendations below so we can all have this resource down below of just anything and everywhere to go see and obviously eat. Also let me know in the comments below like what was most enticing to you in this video. Like even if you haven't been to Santa Fe, what was your favorite? Again, I wanna give a huge thanks to Tourism Santa Fe for allowing Alex and I to experience your incredible city. We had the best time ever. But that's all for me today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and until next time, I will see you in my next one. Mwah!